So we spent a little while on that last video drawing our own celestial sphere. A lot of good lessons in north and south and rising and setting. We saw see a lot of good stuff that the Mintaka on the celestial equator, Dubi here, very far north. It's going to rise in the northeast and set in the northwest, you know, all that kind of good stuff. There's one more thing I wanted to draw on here is what about the 23.5 tropic lines? And you know what I'm talking about, the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. Where would they set on this? Where would they be on this? Well, they'd be where you think. The Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degrees north. So that's going to be sort of like right in here, sort of right between the 38 and the 18. So I'm going to go ahead and draw that in there, maybe as a dotted line, because it's not actually a star, but it just is one of the natural references that we know about. It's one of those lines that the sun interacts with as it goes around and does its thing in the year, sort of right there. And of course, the Tropic of Capricorn is going to be south of the equator, sort of maybe down in this region right here. So sort of draw it up like this and down like that, something like this. And that'll be the 23.5 degrees south. And this one here, let me see if I can squeeze it in. 23.5 degrees north is that line right there. So that'd be the two tropics on my celestial sphere. And so again, on this celestial sphere, I could draw sort of a line like this and say, well, you know what? Because I know the sun is always between the tropics here, this is sort of going to be the extent of the sun's motion on the celestial sphere. Like, in other words, we would never, ever, ever expect the sun to be anywhere over here, too far north, or anywhere down here, too far south. But what we also know about the sun is, unlike the stars, its declination is not constant. And you know this now, maybe not so formally, but remember, the sun goes between 23.5 degrees north to zero to 23.5 degrees south, back to zero, and then back all the way to 23.5 degrees north, all the way in the course of 1 year. And so the declination is always drifting around. So if I wanted to go back up, but let me say one thing, it's drifting around, but it's drifting around very slowly. Because remember, the declination goes from the Tropic of Cancer to Capricorn over the course of a whole year, 365 days. So the declination just doesn't change very much on a day-to-day basis. But how would you capture the sun on this drawing of the celestial sphere also? Well, it's just very risky, but I'll just try to put it on anyway. And given that I'm done with this figure, I guess it's okay to ruin it now. But I'll go ahead and say, well, the sun's sort of going to rise here on one of the solstices here. I don't even know what I'm drawing at this point, but then it'll just sort of keep, it'll rise here later and here later and here later and here later, here later and here later, and a half a year later it'll be on the Tropic of Capricorn, at which point it'll go back. So maybe what I'm drawing here by with all these yellow balls is the rising position of our sun as the year goes on. Maybe I'll choose a slightly thicker line here to say, well, sometimes it's going to rise here over the Tropic of Cancer, other day, and then it's going to set, and it's going to go up like this and set, and go up like this and set. It just covers this whole span of the celestial sphere between the tropics. So that'll sort of be the variable path of the sun. So remember, where Dubi, for example, here always sticks on a 62 degree declination every time it rises and sets, it never changes. The sun doesn't do that. It goes back and forth on the celestial sphere as it rises. And you can even note one last little thing here, which I just noticed. Remember, a little person is standing right here. If I can go back to my thinner line here, standing right here, there's our person. And so when they look up here, look how low the sun is in the sky right here. And what is this for this person? Well, it's winter time for the person because the sun is way down by Australia right there, versus the other time of the year where the sun is rising right here. Look how high the sun is in the sky. That's summertime for this person. We know it's summer. That's when the sun is over the Tropic of Cancer. So you even see in the celestial sphere model here a little bit of the seasons in here as well. So there's a season right to be seen there and a season argument to be made right here. And it's true. The sun is just not as high in the winter months when it's cold for us and can't warm us up. So anyway, I think I'm done then. That's my drawing of the celestial sphere and all the possible dynamics I can think of, including the sun in there, which I'm so happy I squeezed in there at the end.